Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Mohir Jadhav. So guys, first time on this channel, we will going to review a mobile smartphone. Though I'm not a technical expert of reviewing smartphones, but we will just going to see the camera performance of this phone. The smartphone I'm talking about is this, the Samsung A52, which was launched last month. And it has been 25 days that I am using this smartphone. And I'm gonna tell you guys why I think that this smartphone could be the best smartphone to shoot cinematic videos and travel videos or vlogging and YouTube videos and stuff like that, and as well as to capture some good quality images as well. We will also go through some specifications, but we will not talk about the performance and the other things which you can definitely check that out on internet. But we will just going to see how well the camera performs from the professional's point of view. Many of guys, if you don't follow me on Instagram, then you must have know that I shoot videos and edit professionally. From the professional's point of view, we will review this camera and see how it performs. So before starting video guys, do subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and without wasting your time guys, let's get started. So let's talk about the camera specifications. We have here first 12 megapixel ultra wide, a 64 megapixel primary camera, 5 megapixel depth sensing camera and 5 megapixel macro camera. And on the front, we have here 32 megapixel punch hole camera. And the design of this phone is so good, though it's plastic, but has matte finish, which is a new thing Samsung has recently introduced. And personally, I like this matte finish than the glossy one, as it provides much better grip and doesn't leave any fingerprints as well. Also, it has IP67 rating, which means it can survive up to 1 meter deep water for 30 minutes or so. So that is very useful feature to have, especially for travel vloggers. You don't need to worry about rain. So first of all, jump into the video specifications. Here in a more section, we have pro photo mode, and I guess we all have seen the pro photo mode before. It's not new, but down here we have pro video mode as well. And let me tell you guys, this is like having a professional video camera with you guys. I'm very impressed with this new pro video mode guys. Let me tell you why. In here we have first exposure corrections like contrast, highlights, shadows and saturation and tint. All of the settings which we adjust in the post-processing, that adjustments we can do right before hitting the record button. Then we have here white balance adjustment. Then we have focus settings. This is also one of my favorite specifications of this phone guys. In here first we can set it to auto, in which we don't have to worry about the focusing. And 99% of the time it is very fast and accurate. Like you see here, it is focusing very fast and accurate. And then we have manual mode of focusing. Guys, it has also given the focus peaking. That is the first time I have seen this in a smartphone at this price point. Means the subject which is in focus will show green lines around it. You can see how we are easily get to know that which subject is in focus. So that's really cool feature to have. Then of course we have our shutter speed and ISO and frame rates and resolution settings. Now let's see the auto mode of the video. All the sample photos and video I will shortly share with you guys. Now left we have this icon of filters. You can choose various filters from here. It is all common in all phones, but I personally don't use this feature at all. We have face filter as well. Then next we have resolution and frame rate section. And here we have got 720 HD 30fps, 1080p full HD 30fps as well as 60fps and 4K ultra HD with 30fps. These are the frame rates and resolution we have got, but I personally like to shoot in 4K 30fps. Then we have here aspect ratio, like usual I prefer 16:9. And we have here super steady mode. I personally don't like this mode because it degrades your quality of the video, though it has OIS, that is optical image stabilization, built in, so you don't need to worry about the shaky hands. Then we have flash and the settings. In settings we have high efficiency mode, and we can also turn off the built-in OIS. And then we have here the exposure slider. You can adjust the exposure from sliding left to right. Also you can lock the exposure as well. Comes in very handy while shooting in harsh sunlight. Once you lock the exposure, you then no need to worry about the exposure fluctuations. Now let's see the lenses we have. We have ultra wide, which is very sharp indeed. and the details it captures, I think could not match any other ultra-wide angle cameras from this price range, guys. It has 12 megapixel ultra-wide. You can definitely see the amount of details here, guys. And look how well it captured the details from the shadows and the highlights. We have bright sun in the background as well, as it has very high dynamic range. Also, the stabilization just works fine with the ultra wide angle as well. You can shoot excellent quality portrait videos for your Instagram stories as well. This video earlier I uploaded on Instagram story, and many people asked me whether I shot this video on GoPro or external wide angle lens. Now let's see the primary lens and see some sample footages. Here I am shooting with full HD 30fps with OIS on. You can see how smooth the video is looking with no shake. Here's the example in 60fps, which looks much smoother than the 30fps. The one thing I really like here, that how well it is controlling the highlights and shadows. Even you can correct it in post-processing without breaking the footage. So that shows you how good the dynamic range is. तो आप देख सकते हैं फ्रंट कैमरा क्वालिटी, तो आप देख सकते हैं मैं अभी 60fps पे शूट कर रहा हूँ फुल HD, और OIS ऑप्टिकल इमेज स्टेबिलाइजेशन आपको फ्रंट कैमरा में भी दिया हुआ है यहाँ पे, सो दैट इज़ वेरी गुड फॉर व्लॉगर्स आउट देयर. एंड यू कैन सी हाउ इट इज़ कंट्रोलिंग द लाइट बिहाइंड मी. इट इज़ वेल एक्सपोजिंग, मीन्स डार्कर एरियाज काफ़ी ज़्यादा डार्क नहीं लग रहे, और जो हाईलाइटेड एरियाज है इज़ ऑल्सो blending quite well. So Samsung has done a great job on the videos. Now we are recording at 4K 30fps through front camera. तो ये front camera की quality आप देख सकते हैं 4K में, और जैसे कि मैंने पहले ही बताया, काफ़ी अच्छी तरीके से shadows और highlights को ये संभाल रहा है. बिल्कुल vlogging के लिए काफ़ी आसान आपको होगा अगर आप एक व्लॉगर हैं तो. एंड साउंड क्वालिटी भी आप देख सकते हैं, मैं माइक्रोफोन कोई भी यूज़ नहीं कर रहा. और स्टेबिलाइजेशन पे आप देख सकते हो कि 4K में भी काफ़ी अच्छी तरीके से ये स्टेबिलाइज कर देता है फुटेज को. मेरे पीछे ब्राइट सनलाइट है एकदम, फिर भी मेरा जो चेहरा है वो वेल एक्सपोज दिखा रहा है.
नाउ लेट्स सी सम ऑफ द फोटोज ऑफ द अल्ट्रा वाइड एंगल लेंस. सेम एज वीडियो, द डिटेल्स आर वेल प्रिजर्व्ड हियर एज वेल. Now look at the portrait mode, which gives excellent edge detection. Another feature really impressed me, that after shooting in the portrait mode, you can make the background blur with different style, and also you can create this kind of cool effect with just one click. And here are some selfies. I personally do not fancy about taking selfies. You can also tell how good the selfies are.
So that's it for today, guys. Hope you like this video, and if you do, then please comment, share, like, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and we will meet in the next video. Thank you so much.